why you should always stick to large cap stocks. One reason to stick to large cap stocks. So hi, hello, this is Ganesan, your millionaire coach and author of the book Money Leaks. And today we are going to see why many people say that you should stick to large cap stocks. Because this is advice people get when they are coming for the first time into stock market and keep buying stocks. So this is what we are going to see today. So why large cap stocks and one reason to stick to large cap stocks. And because I've seen so many people asking to invest in penny stocks, we'll see the number of reasons why people go to penny stocks and why you should stick to large cap stocks irrespective of that. And what is that large cap stocks? This is what we are going to see today. If you're a conservative investor and you are expecting a safety purpose, safety thing in the stock market too, then this video is for you. Please share with your friends like who are coming into stock market for the first time and they're also looking to my money should be safe. Will my money be safe? Again, it's not a stock recommendation or something, but a condition which you can apply when you're investing in stock market for the first time till you get a hold on like what is the stock market and how it works. Right, let's get into the topic. So please share this video with your friends so that they also know how the stock market works and how this large cap stock works, and they can also create wealth for themselves, right? So let's get into the video. Let's get into the today's session. So what is this large cap stock is all about? Why? And it is also called as blue chip stocks and by various names, but predominantly blue chip stocks or large cap stocks or Sensex top 30 or Nifty top 50. All these are various names given to the top 30, top 50 companies, right? Okay. So predominantly the market capitalization that defines the large cap stocks. For example, as of now, this is the truth that Reliance has a number one stock. Reliance is having the biggest market capitalization in India, 10 lakh crores in market capitalization. So how this market capitalization works and how it has grown like this much. So I have some stats and let me show that stats to you so that you know what it is exactly. So this has been taken a couple of days before. So forget about the last price. It has been a negative because the market was negative. And here the last column, it defines the market capitalization. So Reliance is having 9.8 lakh crores. It's now the price has increased. Today's price is around 1,600 plus and it has almost crossed 10 lakh crores. And next is TCS with 7.7 lakh crores and HDFC Bank close to 7 lakh crores. So all these are 7 lakh crores or 10 lakh crores. Or this is the market capitalization we are talking. And if you see HDFC Bank, it's a home finance division, and ICICI Bank, Kotak Mahindra Bank and SBI. Almost four banks, financial sector is in the large cap sector. And if you see HUL, Hindustan Unilever, the biggest FMCG company, and ITZ, one of the oldest and biggest FMCG company in India, and one of the biggest IT company, Infosys. Though it has gone down, the stock has gone down, it is still close to 3 lakh crores of market capitalization. And TCS, the another software company, and Reliance is the biggest company in India as of now, because of, as you all know, the petrochemical industry, which they have got a strong foothold and they are diversified into Jio, 4G phones, and also with Reliance Trends and all these stuff. So they are a huge company as of now. So they have the biggest market capitalization in India. So these are the companies which you know for the last 20, 30 years and how they have grown. Do you know how this company would have started? Let's share an example, because these are the companies which is in existence for more than 20, 30 years. Let me say company A, for example, company A, when it has been started, any private limited company will be needed to start with 1 lakh crore of market capitalization, and per share value will be around 10. So generally it's like almost 10,000 shares into 10 rupees, the face value of a per share value. So 1 lakh is an investment in your private limited company if you are just starting up. And if you're starting a manufacturing company or anything different, it will be 1 crore of investment or 5 crores of investment. It will be huge. So this is how you will start, the face value with 10 rupees. And once a company starts its operation, once investment comes in, and once all these things come day in and day out operation starts, you will be measuring the results. And probably over the next 3-4 years, your company worth would have been close to 40-50 crores, for example. And by now you want to expand your company. And now if you analyze the face value, the same face value, which started with 10 rupees, now based on the revenue generation, sales, and all these stuff, auditors will be computing the per share value and earnings per share. So all these forms the base of the company, right? So per share value now would have been around 50 rupees. And face value is the same 10, and the company book value, that will be around 50 rupees. And when you, and now you want to expand all over India, or you want to get a loan or something, you want to expand for operations, or you increase your sales, you are in need of money, and you're coming to public. You are asking the public that this is my company, I'm in existence for 4-5 years, and satisfying all the SEBI's requirement, this is most important. And after that, you're coming into the market and asking them like, I'm in the market for these many years, I'm doing this service, and this is my, and you are keeping a premium that instead of 50, you're keeping a premium that 100 rupees is your share value, your company share value, 100 rupees, with a face value of 10 rupees. So if the company's justification is accepted and SEBI approves, you will be coming into the market and asking the public that this is my share value, and it is available in market for initial public for 1 week. That's how you will come into the market. And that's how Maruti, TCS, all these big companies once started with this much share value. Maruti, for example, came into market in 2003. And at that time, their market share was just 11,000 crores. And now if you see, the market cap is around 200 lakhs crores. It's in the top 15 companies. Maruti is in the top 15 companies. And they enjoy a 50% share. And TCS, for example, they came in 2004. And the per share value was, the price band was between 770 to 850 to 900 rupees. And it was subscribed 10 times. And they came into market, I think in the market cap at 47,000 crores or something. And now they have 7.7 lakh crores of market capitalization. That is the kind of growth we are seeing. And do you see any time that HDFC Bank is going to go down or SBI is going to go down? Because the need for banking is huge. And they started somewhere around the same 10,000, 20,000 crores. And now they are sitting at around 3 lakh crores or 200 lakh crores or 4 lakh crores of this market capitalization. And why we are focusing on market capitalization? Well, number one reason is they are huge companies. They are so huge that they are having the corporate governance, that there is a proper government. For example, Infosys had a serious issue last 2 months before that. There was a whistleblower who complained to SEBI and US Department, stock market department, that there is a ethical issue in Infosys, and that needs to be addressed. He had directly sent a mail to them, and it became a hot topic in the stock market, people, among the stock market enthusiasts, because Infosys is one of the top IT companies, and it's difficult to believe that a company with such corporate governance, with people like Nandan Nilekani, Narayana Murthy, the founder, and other people who have been with the company, who had grown them from 1981 till now, it's difficult to believe that they are having corporate ethical issues. So they just stepped in. Nandan Nilekani, who was part of the team, just stepped in and said that we are setting up a external audit company, and they will be monitoring independently, and they'll be submitting the report as soon as possible. This is the kind of management talk we will be expecting of a company of that stature. Because they just came and he just came out and open and said that we don't find any issue, and as far as senior management is considered, and as the report has been sent to the external SEBI, and we are appointing this company, we are appointing an audit company, and we will be doing the external audit, checking all the possibilities, and if there is any issue, we will be addressing it. They just came out and open and addressed the people. So that's how your company should be there, right? So then we will be having the confidence that, yes, this is my Infosys. I can hold the share for long. So this is just an example of how an issue will be addressed if it is a huge company. And the corporate governance and debt to equity ratio, it will be, of all these companies, if you see, the debt to equity ratio will be much smaller, because they'll be either paying on time, or they are not need of money, not need of external funding. For example, HUL doesn't need, IDC doesn't need, all the banking stocks, 4 stocks, SBI, HDFC, HDFC Financial Services, and all these, they are in the banking. They don't need, they are not need of any external debts. and Maruti, though it's about 10, I just showed the example of 10 stocks. So they are having the biggest market share, and they are managing depreciation much lesser of the company of that big. So the number one reason is it's much safer, and the potential in the future is much higher because we are not developed or matured market. And when we compare India with China or US, they both are developed markets, and even Germany, UK or Japan, all are developed markets. The company, all the companies in that market would have gone to the next, either they become a multinational company, they are dependent on other things. But in India, all these companies doesn't need to go out diversify as of now. The requirement in the local market is huge. They need to satisfy the people in India. I mean, they need to cater to the people of India, and that itself is huge. And one single line, if I say that India has ambitious plan of becoming a $5 trillion economy by 2025, which is just 6 years from now. And what is lying ahead? From $2.5 trillion economy, we are moving to $5 trillion economy. It's almost like doubling. Whatever we are here, we are doubling the size of the economy in just 6 years timeline. And what can happen to all these companies? They have the biggest market share. They have the biggest strength to service to the people. And they have the potential to reach to the next level. Whatever the economic condition as of now, either it is dull, recession, whatever the global can say, global economic campaign, whatever the picture. But all these large cap stocks, they are prepared. They have the vision, what they are doing, going to do for the next 5-10 years and for the next 20 years. If the size of the economy is going to grow big, and these are the companies which has the potential to cater to all the people. So banking for all, it's biggest thing, and they need to service to all the bigger companies. So if the company grows bigger, all the banking sector will get benefited by bigger margin, and consumption will increase, and automatically all the FMCG companies will have the potential to cater to all these people if the consumption increases, right? So only reason to stick to large cap stocks is they have the potential to cater to the, if as the market is going to double, I'm saying the economy, not the stock market alone. If the economy is just getting double, just think of what is going to happen to the Sensex. Currently, it's trading at around 40 to 41,000 points. And now economy is reflecting 2.5 trillion dollars, right? So if the economy is getting doubled to $5 trillion economy, what will happen to the stock market? It also naturally needs to get double. That is how it works. Whatever the situation, even if it is going down, market is going down, crashing by 2,000 points or 4,000 points, it will double in the next 6 years. If you believe in the story of India, if you believe in the government, whomsoever the government may be, the potential whole world is dependent on India for the growth. And even if the GDP is less, but when you compare it to the global economy, India's GDP is much better. Look at the positives of what India is having. And India's positive is demography and the young population. All these factors contribute to the fact that large cap stocks are bound to grow big, and you can participate in large cap stocks if you're very conservative initially. So don't worry about any other thing. If you're a first time investor, stick with large cap stocks, come into the stock market and then see what is the potential available with other stocks. You can grow, because in the last 1 year, large cap stocks has driven the market like anything when you compare it with mid cap or small cap. It's a cycle. Don't worry about large, mid or small. Invest in these big companies, top 10, 20 or 30 companies without worrying a lot. Understand the basics of these companies and then put your money in. Bet on them. And again, all the stocks which I had shown, it's not a stock recommendation or not. I'm saying that these are the only things that you should buy. But the reasons you can stick with large cap stocks is what my point is. So if you have any queries with respect to buying a stock in large cap or mid cap or whatever, you can just ping me. And one of the best thing I can say is that the big surprise thing which is awaiting for you people is that my online school is ready. I'm going to offer November is gone, December is came in. So I'm going to offer a stock market related course. And as a preview, I request all of you to be part of my Facebook closed group community so that you can be there, learn a lot about stock markets. And anything related to wealth creation, we can discuss, you can post in your queries and all these things in detail. Just answer the three questions in by clicking the below link, you'll be prompted with 3 questions. Just answer the simple questions and then be part of my Facebook closed group, Unlimited Wealth. So from there, you will be shown like how to be part of my, to learn more on stock market and all those stuffs. We'll discuss more on wealth creation prospects because India's opportunity is huge. You can be part of this growth story and earn a lot of, create a lot of wealth. It's not earning a lot of money, creating a lot of wealth. So thanks for watching. Please share this video with your friends. As I said, who cribs about stock market and who says that stock market is not a place for me. Stock market is a place for everybody, and you can stick with large cap stocks initially and create wealth for yourself. Thank you once again. See you at another video on stock market. Thank you.